If this case does go to the Supreme Court, it could define privacy for a generation. 60 Minutes talked about this issue with FBI Director James Comey and with Apple's CEO Tim Cook.
On your smartphone today, on your iPhone, there's likely health information, there's financial information, there are intimate conversations with your family or your coworkers. There's probably business secrets, and you should have the ability to protect it. And the only way we know how to do that is to encrypt it. Why is that? It's because if there's a way to get in, then somebody will find the way in. There have been people that suggest that we should have a back door, but the reality is if you put a back door in, that back door is for everybody, for good guys and bad guys.
The notion that we would market devices that would allow someone to place themselves beyond the law troubles me a lot. I am a big supporter of the rule of law, but as a country, I don't know why we would want to put people beyond the law. That is, sell cars with trunks that couldn't ever be opened by law enforcement with a court order, or sell an apartment that could never be entered, even by law enforcement.
If the government lays a proper warrant on us today, then we will give the specific information that is requested, because we have to by law. In the case of encrypted communication, we don't have it to give. And so if, like, your iMessages are encrypted, we don't have access to those.
I want to make sure, as they do, that people's privacy is protected. I don't want anyone willy-nilly going through my phone or looking at my pictures of my children. But I also don't want to live in a country where the bad guys know that there's a way for them to be absolutely beyond the law.